Super Mario Maker, isn't it just a great game? I mean, you can make your Mario levels off your dreams with the tools given to you. How awesome is that? And with the 3DS version, you can just make them on the go. I mean, I can't tell you how much I played these games, dude. And Super Mario Maker doing well on the Wii U, like the Wii U didn't sell great at all. It's one of the worst selling Nintendo consoles ever made. And yet Super Mario Maker did great for the Wii U. It sold a lot of copies for like basically every Wii U owner had this game. Then they made the 3DS version, it was kinda lame. But then suddenly, out of nowhere, they just dropped a Mario Maker 2 trailer. Like literally, this was everyone's reaction.
Yo, this is so freaking epic, dude. Holy crap! Mario Maker 2! Oh, that's freaking cool!
It was only right for them to make a sequel. Because Nintendo Switch is so popular, it sold a lot of systems. It'd be only right for them to make Mario Maker to the Switch. And that's what I'm going to be doing today. I'll be talking about a lot of things I want a Super Mario Maker 2. A lot of things. And I know there are already a billion videos of that OD already on YouTube. But I can't freaking help it, man! And I already recorded a review for a different game, but that got corrupt and I don't really feel like doing that all over again. Maybe someday! So that's what I'm doing today. I'll be letting you guys know what I want in Mario Maker, what I like to see. I won't be throwing around really crazy ideas like, I really want a Super Mario 64 theme in there! Like, let's be real, that's probably never gonna happen. If that is, I'm gonna eat a shoe. But I'll be just, you know, telling you guys what I want in Mario Maker that are possible to be in the game. Sure, it's also possible, like, to get, like, Super Mario 64 is gonna be in Mario Maker 2, but I'll be talking about things that are likely to come in Mario Maker 2. So without further ado, let's begin. Alright, so I'll be talking about what items I still want in the game, what bosses I still want in the game, slash enemies, what themes I want in the game, and many more things. Alright, so are we going to be getting with the enemies. The first enemy I would really love to see in Super Mario Maker 2 is the Sumo Brothers. These are basically enemies that stand on platforms and stomp on the ground, making a sort of an earthquake, and also send an electric shock to the ground, while in Super Mario Bros. U, they send an electric thing to the ground and make some shockwaves. On Mario World, they kind of stomp on the ground, making a firewall. So I'd really love to see if like could shake those guys, and that they will either make a firewall or just send electrical waves at you. What would be really cool if you were able to add a mushroom to him and he'll become kind of the boss, like a new Super Mario Bros. U. Or just a bigger version would be cool too, I guess, I don't know. Alright, what kind of fire slash lava enemies do we have in Mario Maker? We got the lava bubbles. That's it, and no, fire cheep cheeps don't count. So what about Blarg? I know, is that really weird, I'm sorry. These are just basically enemies that hide on the lava, peek their eyes out, and if they see you, they go back hiding under the lava, and if you come close, they'll charge at you. These can be eaten with Yoshi. That'll be really cool if you can do that. Or if you give them a mushroom, they become really big. That'll be really awesome. But these are just basically enemies that hide underneath the lava, and if you come close, they peek their eyes out, and if you come closer, they will charge at you. Personally, I think they'll be really cool because then we have some more lava enemies in the game. I would really love to see these in New Super Mario Bros. U, for example, too, but I'm fine if they do. They, like, change in different styles. For example, the New Super Mario Bros. U has this version. Or this version. I prefer that version. Of course, I would like if they have those enemies and Blarks in New Super Mario Bros. U, but I'm fine either way. Alright, so in 3D World, they could have these lava serpent creatures that basically jump out of the lava to come charge at you. And I personally think in 3D World, they're not used a lot. They're just mainly used for aesthetic purpose. Like, if you go through the clear pipe, they jump out. They're not really used as enemies much, but I really love to see them. What would be perfect is if Blarg is in the game with those guys. Alright, this is off today. Thanks to Game Explain. Check out the channel. They showed us a couple screenshots from different styles, and as you can see, they showed the lava serpents. So does that mean Blarg is in the game? I don't know. But as you can see, these are confirmed to be a Mario Maker. I just want to say that in this video, we hear some enemies that are actually in the game confirmed by these screenshots. For example, Meowster's in the game that we'll be talking about later. So don't be like, oh yeah, I want this in Mario Maker. It's like, you're like, hey, this is already confirmed, so why is this in here? I just wanted to let you guys know that. Anyway, continue the video. We got Bullet Bill, Bullseye Bill, and Bonsai Bill coming to Mario Maker 2. Pretty cool now, but what about King Bill? These are gigantic bullet bills that either chase you or just come from somewhere else. These are really hard to dodge. I mean, in the levels they're featured in, they're really easy to dodge because you have a big playground to play with. But these are so cool enemies, and it'll be really fun if you're gonna make like a chase level with these. Like a King Bill's chasing you through a castle or something like that, and you gotta run away from him. And along the way, he destroys brick blocks behind you because you're walking on a brick block path or bricks, I don't know. And suddenly in front of you, there's another King Bill coming at you, and you have to jump, like wall jump, so the King Bill doesn't hit you. I think King Bills will make for great chaotic levels, and it'll be really fun. What'll be really amazing too is if you can set the speed for them. For example, they can go either really fast or really slow. I think it'll be pretty cool. But yeah, I would really love to see these in Mario Maker. And also because the face is derpy. Alright, so what I think could be another really cool cast enemies are those spinning, rotating waffle things. I don't know, they look like waffles. Don't judge me. These are just basically sort of, I'm gonna say it, waffles that spin around a red ball. It'd be really cool if you're allowed to give those balls a mushroom, for example, and the, like, waffles become really big or something like that, or you can give them wings, so, the waffles, I guess, spin really fast. But you know, I'm fine if they just become normal, you can't change the size or anything like that, but I really love to see these in Mario Maker 2, and it'd be nice because then we have some more tower slash castle enemies. This is just something really quick. If we're gonna add bullet bills, also add the torpedoes for underwater levels. I think those would be really cool, so you can have bullet bills underwater. Because currently, if you do a bullet bill underwater, they go really slow. And I'll be really loving the torpedoes. They're basically bullet bills, but they go fast underwater. And if you're gonna add the red one, they follow you around, so I would really love to see those. So in my opinion, the Boo enemies are also pretty lame in Mario Maker 1. We got Boos, and that's pretty much it, and the Boo circles. So what if they add the Bruiser? These are basically boo boxers, I guess, that can destroy brick blocks and also push crates, so if they add crates, you know. And they can't also be killed immediately, you have to jump on them 3 times in a row to kill them. So, they don't just die in one hit, you actually have to jump on them 3 times. Which is really cool if you can actually give them a mushroom or wings to make them bigger or make them fly, I guess. Pretty cool enemies, and I really want to see them. And I have many more enemies too, but now we're gonna just move on to the bosses for a minute. So the bosses in Mario Maker 1 are pretty lame. We got Bowser and Bowser Jr. That's it. So what if you're able to get Bowser 3 mushrooms? So, you can make Bowser bigger in Mario Maker by giving him more mushrooms. But what if you're able to give him 3 mushrooms and he become Mega Bowser? So basically, he acts like the new Super Mario Bros. U final boss. A really big Bowser that doesn't chase, I mean, he could chase you. You could make it into a chase sequence if you want to. But in order to defeat him, you could use fireballs. Or use a clown helicopter from Bowser Jr., for example, to smash down on his head. Maybe there's some different ways to defeat him, but that's just my opinion, like, and how you could defeat him, I guess. So if you land on his head, he becomes, I don't know, he just comes to his shell and, like, spins around a little bit. Kind of like how the Koopalings act and Bowser Jr. So we really love to see this as a boss, like a gigantic Bowser chasing you. Instead of just the normal Bowser, because the normal Bowser we have right now is just basically small Bowser but with bigger fireballs, and I don't know, I think that's pretty lame in my opinion. So when he hits, he does like a wave of fireballs, so I think that'll be really cool into a level, although really chaotic. But you know, I like chaotic stuff. So this is one fight of Bowser I really like to see. The next fight is, in Mario 3D World, we got the Cat Bell. So what if you could use the Cat Bell on Bowser so he becomes the one and only beautiful Meowser. So what attacks does he have? You can maybe dive, like your cat suit, for example. You can, like Mario can dive from Mario 3D World itself, so maybe Bowser can dive. Maybe he can climb up walls. Maybe he can even spit poison out of his mouth. I don't know if they're like fire poison balls, I don't freaking know. But those pretty poisony balls, I guess, he could shoot. And maybe he can just also shoot his regular fireballs. So, if you go to the Nintendo eShop and search up Mario Maker 2, you see a Koopa in a car. So they got me thinking, what if you put Bowser in the car? Maybe his car could change into the car he has in Mario 3D World, for example, and throw balls at you, like footballs, and if you kick him back, he can get hurt. You can also hurt him with fireballs, for example, or like a boomerang, so that means at the boomerang suit. Thank you very much, and in that way, you could defeat him. In Mario Maker 2, they're adding Boom Boom, so here's my answer. Add Pom Pom. Just add Pom Pom, that's it. And my last boss idea, you know what's up, the Koopalings. Add all of them, thank you very much. I don't care if they have the same attack, I would really love if they have different attacks each, of course. Like, for example, Roy can use his Bullet Bill launcher. Lemmy can throw bouncy balls at you, or really big ones. For example, if he's like hit 3 times. And like Larry's just normal. So that means the EC Koopa lane basically. Throw some magic fire wand balls, I guess, at you. And like Wendy can throw her rings at you. Iggy's like normally as Larry, but he can walk through pipes. For example, if you put a pipe, you can put a Koopaling icon on there, and maybe Iggy can walk through there. And like warp between the ceiling and the ground. I told you he's gonna throw a couple crazy ideas here and there. And Little Boy can like clone himself, or if they wanna go the easier way, he can, he's like also acting normal, but he can throw fire wand balls, I guess, that's what I'm gonna call it, at you, but they follow you this time. And with Morton, he could either have just like act normal and have like a ground pound attack. He has like a hammer, he can smash it to the ground, making sort of an earthquake. Or if you want to make it really spicy, add Pokies into the game and let him use them in battle, like you see in New Super Mario Bros. U. I mean, really, this is gonna be my reaction when I see the Koopalings in Mario Maker 2.
Yo, what is the Koopalings?
Just that, then I'll be happy. Alright, so next what we really love to see is some more platforms. So I'm just gonna tell you guys real quick which platforms I want, because otherwise this video is gonna be like 30 minutes long and I don't want that. I mean, it probably is already, but okay. So I'll just be telling which platforms I want, what I think of them, and what they could do real quick, and then we're gonna move on to the next one! So let's go! This thing is nothing spectacular, but I want more colored mushroom platforms. For example, the color blue, the color green, the color pink, I don't know, just more colors. Because I really love blue. Keeping the mushroom trend going, I would really love to see moving mushroom platforms. For example, mushroom platforms that go side to side. I think they'll be really cool for a new, unique platform challenge. You can either move them automatically, or they just stand still, and if you stand on one side, for example, it just tilts that way. So if you stand on the right, it tilts to the right. Alright, the next platforms I really want to see are the cloud platforms. I really want to see these because they're pretty cool, and the only way of bouncing around are the trampolines and the no blocks, and if you shake them using log blocks, I think it's pretty lame, so yeah. But I really like if you're adjusting the length of them. For example, you can have them really long or really small. I think that'd be really cool, and I really like to see those in Mario Maker 2. Alright, the next thing I really want to see are diagonal pipes. Really simple, instead of hopping up, down, left, or right, you can place them diagonally, and I really like to see those too in Mario Maker 2. Next thing I want to be talking about pipes too is cannon pipes. I'd be really liking to see those, and maybe you can adjust the length of them, how high they shoot you. For example, on the ice blocks and the piranha creepers, for example, you're drawing lines to see how far you can shoot them, and I would really love to see that feature adding with the cannon pipes. I really love to see that in Mario Maker 2 too. Keeping the mushroom trend going, I want stretching mushroom platforms. I think they have great puzzle possibilities, actually, and also platforming. Let's talk about the platforming first. For example, you could either pull two, like, spike dudes up there that puke up balls and throw them down, straight down, you know, those spikies. You could have two of them on the platform, and when the platform stretches, the enemy moves, and they throw the balls in a different direction. I think it would be pretty cool. The puzzle possibilities, I think it also has. Hear me out on this one. It's not the best puzzle ever, but for example, you need the stretching mushroom platform in order to hit a P-switch. For example, the throne needs to hit a P-switch, but the mushroom isn't stretched right now. And then eventually, the mushroom is stretched, and then the throne could hit the P-switch. But the throne doesn't move automatically, you actually have to time your jump that the throne moves down in order to hit the P-switch. What you could also do is add some, like, enemies in there to make it a little harder, because basically this is not the most impressive puzzle, let's be real here. But I think using this, for example, could have great puzzle options. This is probably something everyone wants. A world map. I want a world map in the game. I don't care how limited it is, I want a world map. Maybe you can make like your own story mode out of it. I'm just throwing around crazy ideas here. For example, if you've completed your world map, you could click an option to play every level. And you start in the first level, and if you beat in the level, the path moves on. Kind of like how you progress in the new Super Games. For example, you beat a level, and then you can progress. Basically, the path moves forward to the next level. And it'd be really cool if you allowed to choose different themes. For example, you made 8 levels in a grass world and 6 levels in a desert world. It'd be really cool if you have this section grass and the other section desert, for example. And it'd be also really cool if you allowed to draw your own paths and how you're gonna walk to the next level. And you're gonna also have a lot of menus for like decorations and all that stuff. I really want to see a world map creation, because I've always dreamed that since Mario Maker 1 came out. Sadly, it wasn't in there, and they kind of stopped supporting Mario Maker because the Wii U didn't do all the great. I mean, the sales were pretty good in Mario Maker, I'm not gonna lie, but since the Wii U didn't sell too good, they didn't really want to support it, and they just went with Super Mario Maker 2. So I really hope they're gonna add this. Like, this is gonna be my reaction if they're gonna make it in, like, seriously.
YO, THAT'S THE FRICKIN' WORLD MAP!
Is the joke getting overused? Okay, I'm sorry. Next thing is not the most exciting thing, it's about online. If they're gonna allow you to upload levels, which I assume you do, I want them to make a searcher that you can basically search a level by its name. And sure, multiple levels are gonna have the same name, but if you do, then for example, this pops up with every level that are in the surface with that name. Sure, sometimes, if that's gonna be possible, it's also gonna be hard to find the level, but maybe they could do something like let you search up the level and the user instead of just using the code. That is so frick annoying. I mean, we're not freaking kids. What is this? And then the last thing I want to see in Mario Maker 2 is a 3D option where you can make your 3D levels in the style of Mario 64, Mario Sunshine, and Mario Galaxy. Did that go a little bit too far? I mean, so this is gonna be my reaction, of course.
Yo, is that the 3D mode?
That's neat. And that's basically what I want to see in the upcoming Super Mario Maker 2. Of course, the last one was a joke, I'm just joking. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, they already added so much stuff in Mario Maker 2 compared to Mario Maker 1. I mean, they added the Piranha Creepers, they added the 3D World Team, I mean, well, they were freaking out on that. And they added more themes like the Desert, Angry Sun, Tilting Platforms, they added the Jungle theme, maybe a Space theme, maybe a Night theme, I don't know if that's Space or Night theme. But there's already, from one trailer and a couple of, like, screenshots, there's already way more stuff than in Mario Maker 1 and 3DS. This will be enough mystery mushroom, so get out of here. So, Superfort, are you excited for Mario Maker 2? No! Get out of here! But yeah, that's kind of everything I want to see in Mario Maker 2. I didn't make like a top 10 or anything like that. I just want to make just one video about it because I was already done with the video, only I deleted the footage, so I have to do it again. Maybe another time. But because there's certain YouTubers that make 20 freaking videos of one thing. They're like, oh, I want these themes, I want these enemies. What else? Yeah, I think I could also do like 10 crazy ideas I would like to see, or 10 bosses. Like, I just wanted to make this in one video, and this is what I did, basically. Sure, there's like hundreds of enemies I still want to see in Mario Maker 2, and there's like hundreds of other things I still want to see, but are they all possible? Probably not. And I just throw on a couple ideas that are most likely to come to Mario Maker 2. So am I excited for Super Mario Maker 2, also known as Super Cellular Wii U 2? Yes, I really am. I'm definitely gonna see a review on that. So, this is it for today. I just basically showed you everything I want to see. And still a couple months, like two, because I think I released on June 28th, I can now finally take a break! Wait, what is that? What does that say? Oh right, I upload every Saturday. I mean, Sunday. Luckily it's not Saturday. Guess I can still take a freaking break, so I'ma see you guys next week. Oh shit!